the parts that I manufacture, a lot of them are for airplanes or military parts, like the 737, the 777, or 767. And that's just really awesome to know when you look up at an airplane that you made some parts for it. So why I like machining is because I'm a super hands-on person, and it was really awesome to see the whole effect of the stock material turn into the actual part, doing the programming and just watching the machine cut. It was really awesome, and it's really exciting to see like the finished piece and know that your surface finish is great and your tolerance are perfect, and just it's really rewarding and fun to make the parts. When I first got into machining, I went and applied to about 5 different shops, and I had interviews at all of them. I think just being confident in yourself, and you know you're there to do the job and show up and do the job, and they're gonna respect it. And any obstacles, it was kind of just my first shop just feeling a little awkward, being that you're the only girl. But I mean, if it's the right environment and you got the right people around you and they respect you, it's you're just working, you're just one of them. So a mentor that I have here at the Spearman Corporation is Brian. He is an inspector.
One thing I will say about Kailey is she retains what you tell her. If you teach her something, she retains it. So you're not going through explaining the same thing over and over again with her.
The way he's mentored me is when I come to a stop or need help reading the blueprint to get me to keep going with the process, or something wrong with the machines, I'm able to go to him and he'll help me understand.
And anything she can apply from one setting to another, she will do that. So she'll be basically 2 steps ahead the next time she has a question.
I started off at the Steilacoom High School, and then I took the Pierce County Skill Center, which I took a bus there. It was about a 40-minute drive all the way down to Puyallup. The Pierce County Skill Center had their own little booth area, and I saw the composites skateboard, the longboard that they made, and that kind of just, I like skateboarding, so it drew me into there. And after that, did that for 2 years, sparked my machining wants, got into AJAC about a year after I started machining. It's shown me like more shops, because they help with rehire, they help you find shops, so it's kind of just been it's a nice little, just not like a security blanket, but you know, they have someone on your side to kind of help you get through there, which is kind of like a little prissy, you know, because you can do things on your own, but that's what they're there for, so it's awesome.
You know, in this machining world, you hardly find a girls or woman or lady into the machine. In my whole entire 15 years, I think I saw only 3.
It's really not influenced, you know, you don't really see a lot of advertisement or influence to say, hey, you know, females, come work here.
And it's not just for men, it's a woman can do the job. And of course, she loves it, and there's a chance, that's number one. Number two, she's in school. And people in school, that means they're not just going to school because of I just go there just for fun. You go there because you want to get into the industry.
It's a big growth process to get to where I am today. I think overall it's like a morale boost going to AJAC, because it's like you're learning different things throughout these 4 years. And every time you learn something new, you can take it back to work and kind of brag about it or apply it. They work with your employers as well as work with you to help you understand the pay scale, which is really awesome to know that you can climb up in this career. I would tell a young woman around 17 or whatever to definitely, you know, if it's in your heart, it's got to be passion. No matter where you work, you got to have the passion for it. So if it's in you and you're feeling a little nervous, I'd, you know, step on in it. I'd definitely get into AJAC, because they're gonna guide you and support you through that. And you know, go for it. I wouldn't worry about anything, and just be confident in your words and who you are always, and make it through just fine. So don't let any of the men bother you.